Akron Buzz, everyone. I'm your host, Sarah White, and I am thrilled today to bring to you two people that I know, Jennifer Herrick and Karen Freeman. And Jennifer is the Culinary Director of Jobs Akron, and then Karen is the director of the entire program of Jobs Akron. So thank you for being here, ladies.
Well, thank you for having us.
Yeah, I'm excited to just let people know more about this program. So let's go ahead and start off with the general jobs program. And for someone who's never heard about it, go ahead and tell them what it is.
A jobs program came off as a shoot of a teen moms and young moms program that I was director of for a while. And we realized that we started that program to help them parent. And by the time that I was leaving the program, it came down to the fact that we were trying to figure out why they had lost their job at Taco Bell and why they couldn't keep it.
Okay.
So we kind of started to focus more on those skills. So it became apparent to the leaders that we really need to work with them as far as what are good job skills, you know, what are soft skills, which a lot of people don't know soft skills, which I would say are things that your mother probably should have taught you that you may not know, that you don't go pick up a job application in your house slippers or pajama pants. You should probably comb your hair. That there's just things that they don't think about an employer is still looking at. So we work with them on those things. We offer them a mentor when they come into the program so that they're not doing this alone. The mentor will help them evaluate their goals. It'll help them look at their finances. It'll help them look at their schooling. Maybe they've only gone through 9th or 10th grade.
Yeah.
You know, so the mentor will say, wow, you know, maybe our first thing we need to do is to work on your GED. Or maybe you're too old to go to a brick and mortar GED, but there's a program that starts State offers that we can get you in. So the mentors have a lot of insight as to different ways to accomplish the goals that maybe the girls don't think. So we try to get them to think outside their box. Once we get their education where it needs to be headed, we can start looking for employment. And a lot of times there's a lot of obstacles for them. Maybe they don't have transportation, maybe they don't have childcare. And you put those two together, and a lot of people don't
really
think
hard about
a young mom, a young mom who is trying to get to a job, who has kids that go to two different daycares, and she lives on maybe the east side of town, so she's got to figure out how does she get these two kids on a bus with car seats, with strollers, and get them dropped off at two different times and get to work on time.
Right.
So that's where the mentor can come in and say, wow, let's rethink this. Let's look, think outside the box again. So we will do that with them. We work with a United Way agency in Kenmore, the Financial Empowerment Center, which will help the girls budget their money.
Okay, that's great.
It's awesome, and they can go there for free as often as they want. So they can meet with them weekly, and we can kind of come alongside and say, hey, how's your finances coming? You know, what'd you spend your money on this week? Are you out yet? You know, how much did you spend on cigarettes? All these questions that kind of are mom questions, but that's what we do. So we'll work with them on that. We'll work with them on getting their resumes ready, getting them dressed for the interview. Our ultimate goal, and sometimes we're able to achieve this and sometimes we're not, is when this girl is hired, or this mom, is hired into a job, that the mentor will meet with the employer as well and say, wow, you know, this young lady or this mom is part of our program and we mentor her. So if there are any issues that would help her keep her job, that maybe she's at risk for losing it, we'd really like to work with her on
this.
So let us be part of this process. And so for an employer, it's kind of like an insurance policy that he doesn't have to deal with this problem that he's having, because we'll deal with
it. Right, like he can go to you.
And and we'll work it out. And it helps them be a better employee and helps them maintain their job.
Because
a lot of times they're not familiar with workplace issues. You know, just things that happen that we're familiar with that maybe they're not. So we can kind of walk through that with them. So that's our general job program. Any mom can come into it. And we will offer them a mentor. There's no time frame on that. And then we have specific tracks that a mom can come into if they want to get training. And so right now our specific track is culinary, which would be what Jen does.
Yeah, and I've actually gotten to see this firsthand. I have a cousin who is in the program with you guys, and you know what I loved about it is even when she had her baby, she was telling me, oh, my jobs mentor still saw me every week. She was still meeting with this person and still creating that relationship and, you know, continuing that. Now that she's had the baby, we'll be coming back to the culinary program here shortly. So I just got to see it firsthand, which is really cool. So let's talk about the culinary program. So that is your...
That is my baby.
So let's talk about that. I'm excited to hear more about it and let people know about it.
So the funny thing about how the program came, my husband and I were getting back into church, and I've been in culinary since I was 15. So I have these skill sets that normal people don't have.
Right.
You know, because I can ice carve, fruit carve, you know. So other than like cooking for funerals at the church, how am I going to volunteer? So somebody suggested to see Karen. So I'm like, all right, well, I'll go down. I had kind of had this like half-baked idea. I didn't have it fully formatted, thought out, you know. So I met with her for 20 minutes. She's like, okay, I like it, go with it, run it, create it, we'll do it. And that's literally how the Culinary Skills Program came about.
Nice.
So what I did is I've created 3 6-week programs, and each course builds on itself.
Okay.
So the first course is your basics. It's like actually how to read a recipe. You have to read a recipe before you do anything, so you know what you're doing. Proper measuring, whether it's by volume, by weight, by cups, you know, different things like that. It's your knife skills, you know, how to not cut off your finger. Like,
Good things to know.
Like your safety and sanitation. And it builds. Like, so like, with starting today, like today's week is substantial. And when you think of substantial, you kind of think of abundance. So we're going to make like soups and stocks today. And that is stuff you can make in big quantities that you can freeze and save for the entire winter.
Yeah.
And then that is stuff you don't have to spend money on later because you've already done it. Mm-hmm. You know, so that's what you, the first 6 weeks is kind of builds on that. The second 6 weeks, I'm getting them out of their comfort zone. We're going to take those skills, but we're going to cook ethnic food from 6 different countries.
Oh, nice.
So we hit Mexico, France, Haiti, Africa. We do a little bit from Japan and China and stuff. And then we do USA because it's our mission field one, because that's where we have missionaries at. And I tell them, you don't have to actually leave the country to be a missionary. There are missionaries here in the United States doing things like for that. And then for course 3, I call it seeking counsel, because you have to have mentors. And growing up, you have mentors in your field, you have mentors at church, you have mentors in things. So they get to meet some of mine.
Okay.
So I have guest chefs come in and teach them, because there are different personalities in the kitchen.
Absolutely.
Some run their kitchens like Gordon Ramsay, some don't. You know, so it gets them to the different personalities. Course 3 is the fun one. We go on field trips, so they get to eat at different places they would never normally go. Some little finer dining ones. We do some etiquette with them and different things like that. But then 1 week of the course 3 is they actually take their safety and serve-safe test. So that puts them a step ahead of other applicants.
Right. So when they leave, they get to go away with, what do they have when they leave? It's actually a certificate, right?
It is. So they'll get a certificate of completion for each course.
Okay.
So they'll have 3 of those, plus their serve-safe safety and sanitation, their level 1, which the state has up to, like, more people in your restaurant have to have the level 1, and then the managers have the level 2. So this puts them a step ahead of an applicant coming in who doesn't have anything.
Yeah, that's really cool. So, and then they can actually take what they learned at the culinary program, and you guys help them to get a job, possibly even work in your cafe, which is going to be opening really soon,
really soon.
On the boulevard called Little Bit Cafe.
Yes.
So I just wanted to mention that so people can keep their eyes open for that, which is really awesome. And just, can we do super fast? I want to talk about the Children's Hospital Career Launch Program for like 30 seconds, and then we're going to have to wrap it up.
Great. The Career Launch Program is something Children's Hospital has done, and it is a program where employees can come on at entry level, minimum wage jobs, and through this program they can get a 2-year associate's degree in 1 of 4 areas. So what we like to do is we have come alongside of Children's, and we like to take moms that are interested. We will funnel them into that program and then kind of walk with them through that and do some additional tutoring as needed and kind of make sure that we help them to be good employees and they can succeed in the program.
Yeah, I love that. Okay, so if people want to find out more about any of these areas, they can go to your Facebook page. It's capital J-O-B-S, all of those are capitalized, - Jump On Board for Success, so you can find it that way. Or you can contact these ladies at jumponboardforsuccess@gmail.com. So either way, people can find out more about the program that way. And their website is under construction, so you can keep an eye open for that later as well. Thank you guys so much for being here.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sarah.
Yeah, we had a really good talk. I feel like we got across a lot of information for people, and hopefully you'll have some people interested in the jobs program as well. Thank you guys for being here with me today. We had a great time here in Akron Buzz, and we'll see you guys next time.